Sound design.
All right, so I've talked to you before about free audio analyzers that you can get, so you don't have to immediately drop $500 or $1,000 on your software to get started. You can get started with free things that I've already talked about before, like Room EQ Wizard or Rita from Educasound. There's a new piece of software, though, that I'm just testing out for the first time, Open Sound Meter. And the reason why I want to demo it for you today is that I really like its minimalist approach, and it also is really attempting to look like your other audio analyzers, like your Smart and your Sat Live. It has all the kind of modules you expect. We're looking at the RTA. It also has magnitude, phase, and impulse. You'll notice there's very few controls here, so no menus on the top. To get access to anything, you have to click on something first, and then you can change it. So right now we're looking at the RTA display, and I could change this to bars. So this probably looks familiar to you. After playing with it for just 30 minutes today, my conclusion is that I think it is a great entry-level piece of software, especially for the price of free. Now it has a handful of limitations that I want to expose you to, so you'll understand it. And I think if you just know about the limitations, you can use it and actually get some good work out of it. First limitation is that the minimum here with this Y offset scale is negative 90. Now, if we were looking at this in Smart, I'd be able to scroll down even farther. And if I change this back to line, this will make more sense. So see, we can't even see this information down here. Just good to know that. I could adjust the levels here coming in and probably change that offset and be able to see the entire graph. Let's take a look at the transfer function. So I switch this to double. And if you want to know, this is what triple looks like, and then I can set these to whatever I want. So here is the auto set delay, as you would expect. And here I'm just measuring an EQ. This is kind of what you would expect, right? You've got magnitude up here in the top, phase down here in the bottom. You may notice that there's some jumping around down here. This is probably the biggest problem I have with this audio analyzer software so far. This bothers me. I don't know why. You can never get this stable. I'll show you what happens when I try to get it stable, but you can never quite get this stable, even when I'm measuring something so stable as just an EQ. Over here, if I turn up the averages, let's say I turn them up to 50. Okay, gets a little bit more stable, but still jumping around a little bit. So if you want to use this software, just be aware of this limitation. And you know, you're gonna have to kind of look at the trend here and not these little things jumping around. It might be a good idea to, you know, store a couple of things, and then you can see, you know, do some optical averaging here just with your eye. Okay, let me make these go away. And let me turn this up to maximum averages now. So even at 100 averages, the maximum setting, actually, it's gotten a lot better now. Okay, see, that's still changing a little bit, but notice we only have a problem down here like around 50 hertz. So if you're doing a lot of measuring of subwoofers, this may be a problem for you, but for the vast majority of the frequency spectrum here, it's really stable. So let me show you what happens though when I try to get even more definition here and stability. So if I change this, the FFT size to its maximum setting. Wow, look at that, it starts freaking out. These meters here go way off, so I have to turn this down or it's going to crash. So I'll set this back to 10, this back to 14, the meters go back to normal, everything's okay. Let me show you what's happening here. Okay, granted, ScreenFlow is taking a lot of the CPU right now, but watch the open sound meter as I turn this stuff up. So if I go from 10 to 100 averages, and then go from 14, well, let's just watch the open sound meter for a second. But it's really this FFT size that's making a huge change in, I guess, how much processing it has to do. And my computer just can't handle it. Look at that, open sound meter goes up to 88%, okay? So then I have to turn it back down. So that is the reason for, I guess, some of these limitations. It also doesn't have MTW, which I think would help with some of this. MTW is an option for the FFT size in your audio analyzers like Smart and Sat Live. Probably will be incorporated into Open Sound Meter in the future, I assume. Let me show you, what was one more thing I was gonna do? Oh yeah, I was gonna change these inputs to, instead of just measuring an EQ, now I'm measuring a real speaker, but really close, just like a meter away from a speaker is a recording, so this has gone all crazy, so obviously I need to auto-apply estimated delay. Here's the last problem I'll tell you about. I don't know what's going on with these lines jumping around here. Okay, so this bothers me, and if I set this averaging up to something higher, and if I change the resolution here to maybe even higher than I really need it to be, and if I change the FFT size to something slightly higher, it's not so bad, but they're still there. Just notice that you can still use this. You'll just kind of have to look at the trend here of the phase and kind of ignore whatever these things are jumping around. I'll hit store and then turn off the live measurement. Now I'm not looking at those things jumping around. Okay, so that's probably a safer way to use this software. So I'll turn that back on the live trace. I'll store a couple more. Now we'll just look at these all together. Now I can kind of look at the trend going on here and kind of ignore this extraneous stuff, right? Open Sound Meter, I'll put a link to it below this video. You're not gonna find it if you Google it. You will find it if you search for it in Facebook. It is right now a free piece of software, so I recommend you test it out. And the guy who's making it is just taking donations through PayPal, so you might throw him a few bucks. He's got a link on the webpage there. But let me know what you guys think. Maybe you see something I'm not doing. Maybe I'm using it improperly, and that's why I'm getting these strange artifacts in the graph. Anyway, I think this is one of now several great options we have for free audio analyzers to get you started.
Sound design.